super interesting and fun topic. I've been interested in the triangle since third grade, and it's a big mystery that no one solved, and I love mysteries. The Bermuda Triangle is located off the coast of Florida. Florida is one of the corners of Puerto Rico and Bermuda. The triangle is 440,000 square miles, and it is in the Atlantic Ocean. Planes. Hundreds of planes have vanished in the triangle. The first plane vanished in 1945 when five Navy planes went on a training session and never returned. The most recent plane vanished in 2008 when a Briton Norman Islander took off and vanished after going through the triangle. Here's a quick 1 minute video.
Here's a look at this day in history. December 5th.
In 1848, the California Gold Rush began. Won by the National President James Polk, a gold nuggets had been discovered in California. On this day in 1933, Prohibition, California, speakers, flappers, and mobsters, ended with the passage of the 21st Amendment to the Constitution. This day in 1994, Republicans chose Newt Gingrich, the first Republican Speaker of the House in some 40 years. On this day in 1945, the Bermuda Triangle allegedly swallowed five Navy planes and 14 men. 2 hours after takeoff from Florida base, Flight 19 radioed that their position was unknown, and then they vanished. No trace was ever found. And that's this day in history.
Ships. Many ships of all sizes have vanished. One of the most famous boat disappearances was in 1918 when the USS Cyclops disappeared but was never found. The most recent boat disappearances was in 2004 when several fishing boats went missing. There have been no aircraft carriers that have vanished. Just wanted to show different sizes. Theories. There are many theories, like UFO, methane gas, and the lost Atlantis theories. My theory is that Earth's magnetic fields are constantly changing, causing compasses to point north. But in the Bermuda Triangle, the magnetic fields are not changing, resulting to make compasses change directions, also pulling ships and planes under the water. I'll show you an example. So I gathered this example of why ships and planes go under. So this is the boat, and it goes across, and then there's some type of magnet down there that pulls them down under the water. And then they just sink, and that's why all the debris just stays there, and they can't find any of it.
Why don't you demonstrate it one more time so the kids can see?
Bibliography.
waves out of the air. Yes. Would you think magnetic field is going up, pulling planes up?
I think they're most likely falling down, and they're just so super strong.
Can you demonstrate the magnetic thing again?
About your theory about the magnetic field, I don't really think it would do good because wouldn't you think that they would have gone under to see if they found any plane crashes or anything?
Yeah, but if they go under, they'd disappear and then they wouldn't be able to.
Well, then again, there must be one exception.
Is it like in the middle? Is it like in the middle of the north and south? I have an answer to Cody's question. Yes, one of the planes out of the five who disappeared has been found, and that was the lead plane, but most likely all the others are down somewhere.
Yes. But wouldn't they have found all of them if there was a magnetic force?
They only found one. They were doing training exercises, so they're wider apart, I bet, so they didn't hit each other.
I think that's why it's one of those mysteries, Cody.
Rubber duckies don't have any metal in them.
I put metal in them. There's just some steel inside of it.
If that theory is, could you drive a wooden boat over it?
Yeah.
Andrea, there's a lot of stuff. The alarm's going to go pretty soon, so I guess it's all pretty quick. They might not do it because I told my presentation. So, Andre, do you have a question?
What makes the triangle so special?
Nobody really knows what happens to the plane to ships.
Room 21.